Chris Cotter, West 1575, County Highway J. So I've lived across from there for 45 years. Used to be Danner Bay's, Paul Lunch, talk about noise, talk about problems, there's problems. These comes one, it's all. This is good for the community, we need something else. I've been looking at a hole in the ground for 2 years, as my neighbor said. And another thing is about, since double D's went down, the speed limit on Highway J between Horseshoe Lane and up the hill is 60 now. It's crazy. This will slow that down, or just chill, or hear some music, everybody should be good.
Public comments.
Bob Jansen. N9535. It was mentioned that they had music when it was double D's. But that was twice a year, two concerts at Labor Day weekend. You mentioned that this was a bar. Jim Nels, the attorney. It's an outdoor venue, it's not a bar, there's no wall, there's no, nothing to stop that sound. That's all I have to say.
I support this. Somebody mentioned earlier, we needed options on the lake. We used to have Javels, we used to have Lindy's, we used to have Dan's. Now we have one thing. I think the applicant has shown he's flexible. He already said he's going to time from 10 to 9. He's already talked about it's not Alpine Valley East. Gives us options on the lake.
Anyone else? Public comment.
My name is Joe Sheeran. My I represent Miko and Thomas and Davis LLC. And I apologize for my voice, I was still kind of calling from a cold. So, kind of my pleasure here to back clean up on this and answer some questions. I first want to remind everybody about Act 67, which has been discussed. And there's been a lot of discussion here that has to do with things that are primarily zoning or primarily overall concerns. And I want to make sure that we'll be focused on this discussion and being reminded that this is a use issue and that use issue shall be approved according to the requirements of the ordinance. And we also remind people that it is not sufficient for personal preference to deny uses. That is case law and that is statute. So with that in context, I would also note that I think there's been a lot of confusion that Mika was speaking to that. When he talks about events, he's not talking about concerts. He's talking about having someone play acoustic or some other things during dinner and eating. He's not talking about massive gatherings where hundreds of people are showing up. It's a relatively small business of a couple of the containers and container bars. And I think that's an important perspective to have. When it comes to a lot of this discussion, there hasn't been a lot of facts offered. There's been a lot of interpretation of the zoning code, which is not relevant here and mostly inaccurate. The point that we're really getting to here is Luca's trying to accommodate his business in the community. He's willing to do a whole lot of different things that seem very reasonable. And sounds like the sounds that we're talking about getting when he's raised are going to be less than, say, the person driving around up like your pier blasting songs on a weekend. And as we all know from being out of my way, that sound travels much further than something that's set back about 60 feet and across a road from the actual lot. So it's something here where MECO will try to accommodate. Last but not least, it's important to us, this property is under contract. If we send it back, that's gonna set back our development. We have limited timeframes under the contract, we're gonna have to seek extensions. That is a significant hardship for us in terms of sending us back. This has been a fantastic public hearing, and lots of people have been heard and have raised a lot of good points in both directions. I would advocate that we not send this back and get this decision done at this point, because otherwise it prejudices my client overall. At the end of the day, you have to be fair to all the uses within what the zoning is. And MECO has offered, he's met every requirement that's been put to him, and he's not failed to stand up when you guys have asked him to make changes. I think that deserves consideration next. Thank you.
Mike Mikulajczyk, N-541 Horseshoe Lane. I'll get you the spelling later. It's in the other. I've been to more rock concerts than most people in this room, so I've been my age. And we moved into Lake Hill area 15 years ago. And one of the reasons was the reputation for tranquility and peacefulness. And it's very much lived up to that. And we have nothing against music, we have nothing against a place to go camp. The difference is the lack of walls, the indoor versus outdoor venue. And if it was acoustic guitar, I didn't think we'd have a problem with that. The one thing I would change though is going from May to November, even and having in a weekday event 11 hours, this kid's in school in May. This kid's in school in September, October. That's very respectful of the kids that have to study. Hard enough as it is. We don't have kids that age, but a lot of people do. But we would be all for it if it was acoustic and if it was more control in the environment. It's just that, that's the thing that concerns us more than anything. We do not want to change the character of this lake. We've been here 15 years, we've got the luck of what it is. We know people that have been here 25, 30 years, and people that are multi-generations. And they all pretty much like it the same.
Next. Anyone else? Make sure, I don't want to have anybody out in the hallway that wanted to talk that didn't come in. Everybody good? I don't want to have any problems.
I'll say something. I don't have a direct geographic impact to this proposed venue, but I have mentioned even to you, Joe, at times that we could use some more gathering places, restaurants, that type of thing. I know this is an open venue, but I've heard a lot of people say something about the increased traffic, the refuse and all this stuff. Double D's got all that. So I don't know how that's relevant, because Double D's had it, and it sounds like the architect has that figured out. So I just thought I'd voice my word, or my vote for a, I'd like to see if it could fly and what it would look like. The second thing I wanted to sound out, I wanted to change the tone, is DPW, I wanted to shout out for Todd, 33 trees in that down. I have two down. I appreciate having the recycling center kept open that week. So that was really a big help. And I don't know that he gets enough praise. So thank you.
Todd, you still here?
He's outside.
He's on vacation.
He's cutting trees now.
He's cutting trees. All right. Public comments. Last call.
Right here. Steve Greeley, North Lane, 41 Island Drive. I'd like to ask each board member when you decide to vote, would you approve this in your neighborhood, in your backyard? Because this is in my backyard. We hear voices. We hear the music from Double D's. We got boats on the lake. It's just enough is enough. This venue would be great if it was indoors. Outdoors. In a residential area, it just does not make any sense. And regarding the comment that I don't like it, I can leave my home. I want a refund on my taxes for 74 events. Thank
you. Public comments. That's the last call.
Indoors.
All right. We're going to move forward here. Thank you. And thank you all for coming. Todd, you're out to hall. Yeah. Todd actually done a case this week. He's got different questions. All right. Back to the agenda. Report of committee. Chairperson report. My meeting report. On July 11th, I attended the public hearing for the Dresden dredging project on Lake Lula. On the 17th, I met with the East Troy Railroad Museum CEO and president to discuss the purchase agreement for the Beach Road Bridge. On 7/18, Tri-Troy meeting, discussion points were the joint library, EMS, and other group shared services. And on the 7th of August, Todd and I met with the Wisconsin DNR to review or inspect the closed landfill, which is at the compost site, where they come, so to speak, 50 years ago. It's not a landfill site, compost site. And in addition, somebody mentioned the hotel. I think I had more phone calls and emails on Double B than ever before. And public input counts. And I do appreciate that people are still engaged with the process, because this is the process. And we'll discuss a little later on how we get to some type of resolution. So, that is all I have for my media report. All right, media IG report. Jim Austin.
Just take a time, we're not gonna go verbatim. I do have a rough draft of the fall newsletter attached. It will be coming back, I can do that on most of your, probably should be printed out. To show, we would need the final draft approved next month in order to be able to add six pages later. I do have, if the board would be willing to give a motion to give the administrative team the autonomy to decide how to print and mail this newsletter in a way that will allow us to remain as close to our budget as we can for the rest of the calendar year, and then revisit the process to have a solid plan and budget for the newsletter going forward this year.
I know last time we had kind of employee time, there's more. Where do you come up with certain things? I don't know.
We're just looking for a name, so we put that in.
I will tell you, when I read that, that's the first thing I thought of, probably true.
That's exactly what it meant to say.
Tongue in cheek.
It was very tongue in cheek. Because every suggestion I got kind of went back to the, with a kind of some different qualification. So, we want the circular file, but there's not one.
Anybody have any further suggestions? Report? Bulletin? All right, so send input to you on that. And any comments, I did have a couple comments on this, and also send it to you.
I'll make a motion to give the administrative team the autonomy to choose how to print and mail the fall 2023 newsletter edition.
One second. Second, discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, done, please.
We do have exciting news, the YouTube page is now live and linked to the website. As seen in the illustration in the packet, all you have to do is click on the video, which will show up by tomorrow morning for this meeting. I would have to manually upload it every time to YouTube, but it doesn't take that much time. So it's an exciting step forward to make our actual website a one-stop shop instead of driving traffic to Facebook, we're driving traffic back to the website. Facebook has 64 new Facebook followers this month, 400 content interactions, and 609 photo views. That's up 486 last month, so it's a pretty significant increase. We did go live on the YouTube page on Friday and already have 18 followers. So that's a pretty significant jump in a couple days.
But you're still working to integrate when it's live.
In the right process. I just want to obviously get the sound going because we had an issue with that tonight, so we're pumping. And then from there, just get everything to work out together and put into plans.
But so far, so good. And
so far, so good. It's just really the sound, but it doesn't want to recognize YouTube, does not look like that. So, and today the camera doesn't look like it either. So, our IT company did have some suggestions and we can work with them to see if we can get together. But they were good suggestions, they seem pretty logical. So, hopefully by next month we'll have exciting. Thank you very much.
Any questions for Jim? Thank you very much. Okay, Department of Public Works.
Not much. We had, reiterated our storm a couple weeks ago was a little challenging. Took a while to get things open. That's why we decided to leave the whole thing out site open for a whole week. We did this back in 2012, I believe, the same thing. It was the best for everybody. But, in mind, I got a couple of things that I need to bring to the board. Because Salvation Army wants to do a sewer extension there's a house that's right across from the soccer field that they have bought.
I'm excited to hear it.
But they want to run, because there's, they're part of the sanitary district, but they're contracted with the village. They have their own wet well pumping system that pumps into the sanitary land that runs along Highway ES. They want to run a line from that house down along Army Lake Road, under Army Lake Road, that lift station. So it's kind of like a permanent fix. But that, that has to come through our planning and zoning. I know it has to, because it's in a, it's going to be ran in our right of way. It's like, copy Jim, Joe, contacted Joel Cook. He's going to be working with the engineer for that whole thing. It's just something that they're going to see if it's even going to be feasible to do. But I wanted you guys to be aware of it, because they're going to be operating in our right of way.
There are a lot of conditions on restoration, et cetera.
Yep.
And I did verify it's in their own district and the Sanctuary Service area, and it's all their property that they're serving.
And it's just, it's a whole set of pavilion that they want to add to it. It's going to be a private line. It's not going to be like a city sewer line by any means. So I had a couple questions from some people that had found out that, okay, is this the start of the extension of the sewer anomaly? I said, by no means. Completely private.
But it's private, but it's also its own separate property. Is there,
yep.
They have its own in all of their entire property.
Yep. It's all part of the salvation. And last month we had brought up Attorney Mills had sent a letter out for our road repair at Mills Blue Book. So following up with that, they are supposed to be out sometime this week to fix the driveway, hopefully. And he's going to give me some kind of in writing guarantee. I talked to him last week for his year guarantee on this. The unit, it's an infrared unit. The asphalt contractor has been out of the state with it, so they haven't had a chance to get back here. But when I talked to Bob Portis last week, who is the asphalt contractor, he says, yeah, it'll be the beginning part of this week.
Property owners, the
water,
they're choosing.
Yeah, Custom Green, who actually did the damage, that's who they contracted. They're also the ones that tried to fix it last year.
Okay. So it's not like you had to go
initiate
it. They
nope.
Had, they did respond.
Yeah.
And that's it.
I've just been trying to
coordinate.
Yeah,
yeah.
Get them to move along so it doesn't like last year. Didn't
too cold.
Too cold.
The ultimate deal will be if they cannot repair it, then we will make that happen, and then that charge will land the landfill.
Yeah, it'll be up to us to accept a repair and see what last year. Because right. There's a little fix that they tried last year, but you can make it through the line. So, we started a little bit out here for the new garage that's coming up. Just a little bit of preliminary getting blacktop out of the way and get ready for also the new park side. Just going to get some trees out of the way. It's just a little more than we did, so it's less that they got stuff that's in their way, because it would have been trees that was had a chance to fall on the building, so we just did a little bit.
The next item is one that I asked to be moved from 10. Tennessee. I'm asking permission to work with Todd and the town staff regarding a Office of Energy Innovation Readiness Refueling Grant. I became aware of this $10,000 grant through the Public Service Commission. It would allow us to put a cap switch, which would allow our fuel to switch to a generator in the event that the town hall campus lost power. This would become exceptionally vital should we have a power outage during elections.
It's something that I got brought aware of a month or so ago, and I got in contact with Barb because she's wrote a number of grants. It's just a matter of waiting for that start date for that grant.
The grant was supposed to be open in June. everything I read on the grant, I spent a couple of weekends working on it, and everything I read said the grant had closed. So I called the I emailed the PSE and said, here's your verbiage, what am I missing? Because this grant is supposed to be open until the end of December. It is still only open until the end of December, but I would need to work with Todd and probably the office staff, because I can start working on the grant. What I need is a system for award management, a universal entity identifier, a PSC grant system, a public service commission grant systems login, and an electronic records filing system. And they do have directions on how to set it up. I probably have to sit down with Kim and make sure we didn't already have it, but I'm asking the board's permission to continue to work on this grant. We are in a good position to acquire this $10,000, which would cover the cost of the grant, the switch that we
let's call it a transfer switch, which when the power goes out, it takes it from the pole power or underground power and switches it over to that. Reading through some of it, it might even cost their efficient sum for the generator itself, which I have estimates from two different companies that back with generators. Because I'd like to also get them.
Certainly apply for that. Yeah. All right, do you have a motion for that?
I move that we authorize our supervisor Church to work with DPW to submit the company refueling readiness program grant.
Second. We have a motion second. Discussion. Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. Motion carries.
Thank you.
All right, that's it for you.
Okay.
All right.
Great. I want to say kudos and thank you on both that LRIP money that you got back from 2018.
Yeah.
$15,000.
Yeah. Kim helped with that. Mm-hmm. Back then, there was a contractor that was low bid. He actually had some lawsuits against the municipality, and that's why we were able to take it. It was just right getting the proper letter written and worded right in order to get the funds.
It was denied because we did not take the low bid. We had reason for it, which is our right to do. And I was explained to the DOT director several times, but I guess he wanted to see it written differently.
Somehow written
differently. I think that was the third try.
Amy Lono is at the Flower County. She's the head of the program. She helped quite a bit saying, okay, this is what was written last time. This is what we'd like to see.
What was the final count on all the trees?
33.
Yeah, Echo Jones, thank you. I know that sent her back a couple times in the long weekend.
Yeah.
And thanks for clearing all the trees in the town park, because I know there were quite a few down there.
Okay, thank you so much. All right, please report. Chief Brecky.